If you're out there, you see a great picture, take a picture of it, send it to us at pix@mysuncoast.com. And Elodie answered the call from earlier today, and I'll show you in a minute. Look over Sarasota Bay from our Van Wezel cam. A few puffy clouds, otherwise a picture-perfect day. A little windy to be able to sail on the bay from our sailing squadron, but I think those winds are easing up tonight, and they'll be from a slightly different direction tomorrow, helping those sailors from the squadron. Now, here is from the Sarasota National down in Venice. Joyce King sent a sunrise this morning over the lake. What a beautiful steamy lake picture there. And Donald Townsend seems to think that's a gator in the sky. Can you kind of see that? There's the snout and there's the head. It could be a gator. We like creative, arty pictures. Send them to pix@mysuncoast.com. And look at this beautiful sandhill cranes. A couple of babies there sent in by Amy Johansson. Thank you so much for those pictures. We love seeing them. Really livens up our weathercast. 66, the current temperature at the airport. Dew point 52. The humidity's up to 60%. East winds no longer over 10 miles an hour, but they'll pick up again tomorrow. But as long as those winds are blowing, the fire danger is going to be very high. And you can see they're under about 10 miles an hour under for the most part. Anna Maria, I think, a little gusty there, 16 miles per hour. And in southern Sarasota County and Charlotte County, still above 10 miles an hour in several locations. But there'll be a lot less tomorrow, I think, in most places than we saw this afternoon. You can see that easterly flow in the individual cumulus clouds blowing in from the Atlantic, but just a few of them making it all the way to the Gulf Coast. Radar, nothing showing up other than some ground clutter here and there. However, that's not the case in Texas, which for the second day in a row is under the gun for a threat of severe thunderstorms. And this outlook from the Storm Prediction Center shows down around San Antonio today and tomorrow over toward Houston and in Louisiana. And we do have a couple of severe thunderstorm watch boxes down there around San Antonio. One storm around Laredo is heading up I-10 towards San Antonio. Going to be a stormy night in South Texas. And it's all fueled by that little area of warmth there, over 80 degrees. And when it warms up again tomorrow, the storms will be farther east. Well, here's our future cast showing that we have those easterly winds. But look what happens in the next couple of days as high pressure drifts southward. The winds start coming in from the southeast and then from the south. That's warm and somewhat humid. And here comes that front triggering the storms tonight in South Texas. What's going to happen? This is only out to 48 hours from our RPM computer model. Let's go to our long range future cast from the European Center. And it shows the front coming through on Friday. And by Friday evening, it still looks impressive. You know, not too bad. Maybe we'll get some rain, but unfortunately, it kind of dissipates overnight, and by Saturday morning, just a few clouds and a few sprinkles. But look what happens for Easter Sunday. The sky's clear, and it looks like a beautiful, sparkling day for Easter sunrise service and the rest of the day for enjoying the outdoors. Out on the water tomorrow, southeast winds at 15, maybe a few higher gust seas, 2 feet, a chop on the bay. 80 degrees, the bay temperature, UV index 10, with a water temperature of 69 to 70. Here's my forecast for tonight. A few clouds like you see there, 58 for the overnight low, and tomorrow a partly sunny day, a beautiful day, a little breezy at times, 81 the high. And here's your 7-day showing breezy conditions off and on right on through Friday. Then the front comes through with a 30% chance of showers, very slight chance on Saturday, clearing out for an 81 degree high on Sunday and staying dry next week. Jacqueline?
Okay, thank you so much, Steve.